All right. In this edition of Wisdom from the Workshop, I'm going to show you how to build a metal cutting table saw for under $30. Worst case scenario, $30. Now, I have the bench grinder, aka Princess Leia. It has enough power. It has power to grind and shape metal, but it doesn't have the speed to cut. To be able to do that, it just won't do it. It'll basically stop moving. Now, I've invented my own stuff for my own needs before. This beautiful thing, I call it a pallet buster. Now, it's actually two different wedges with straight angles. This wedge here is for pounding in this direction. This long hook is for pounding in this direction. Now, the first thing on your shopping list should be an angle grinder. At a good hardware store, these run anywhere from $15 to all the way up to, you know, $2,000, believe it or not. This is a nice $30 one. The one I'm actually using in my table saw cost me about $15. Now, number two on your list is going to be clamps. Lots and lots of clamps. I actually own about 15 of these. And you have no idea how many clamps you will acquire if you do anything, any kind of precision carpentry, metalwork, etc. I found this guy. The price tag on this one was $2. Well, the part was. I prefer hardwoods. I use a lot of oak with I do because I have the pallet buster. I can get the wood pallets for free. So really nice hardwoods can literally cost you nothing. What you need is something adjustable that you can basically hold onto an X, Y direction. This will clamp, something that will lock down. You have to have a clamp that can extend and then lock into place. As opposed to the C clamps, which are great for holding something in place, but this one will actually allow whatever it is to slide through it without moving from side to side. Number three on your list is going to be these. These are called hose clamps. Something like this thing right here. This is a small one. Basically, it is a 16th inch steel with a screw on the end of it, so you can actually make this much, much tighter than you can on your own with your just basically finger tight. Next, get yourself a nice, cheap bag of zip ties. These can often be bought from major hardware stores for about $1. You do not want the good ones. You do not need the good ones. These will break. You will make major adjustments, not only when you're building it, but when you want to switch projects. Go cheap on these. Next, you want the stanchion boards. That means the center horizontal boards off of a wood pallet. Odds are you don't have a pallet buster. You can do it with just basically the claw hammer. It's not as efficient, but it will work. You've got all of your materials together, or at least what you think will do the job, you'll end up with this. Isn't it beautiful? Number one rule of tools, at least my number one rule. Tools don't need to be pretty, they need to be functional. They do occasionally need to be clean. This is just a piece of crap steel that I picked up. I don't even know what I got it from, okay? But frankly, if you take the guard off of an angle grinder, it will basically 85 to 90% of all the hot slag will follow a nice, predictable fashion. Usually running from the right as you face down from the angle grinder, basically because an angle grinder does move in a clockwise motion. This is for the last 15%. You don't want it to fly around the shop. You also don't want it to fly out of your skin. Frankly, angle grinder slag, it's not the worst stuff in the world, but if you get hit with it enough, you're just going to be pretty raw for about a day. Something else I didn't mention you do want to go for is something to hold it on. I got very, very lucky with this particular piece of hardware. This is actually for a wood jig. I bought it used for $2. Basically, it is just a basic clamp. Now, I took my secondary angle grinder, threw it through, nice little cut right here, about halfway through, because you want the thing to be centered. You want anything to, okay, take two. Now, what you want to take this clamp, slice it up the center so that you can attach, four. take this clamp, and then you want to cut it through the center. Always center your work. It's more of an issue of leverage than anything else. Then use your hose clamp to attach it. Then use your engine epoxy in order to basically prevent it from falling out. Engine epoxy is what I prefer. If you can weld it, if you know what you're doing to weld, it's great. The only reason I didn't weld it is because this metal is so thin, I was afraid I would warp it. So I went with the engine epoxy and just was basically done. I used the zip ties, mostly for added stability and also to absorb some of the vibration. All of this, all of the wood here, nice white oak, is to absorb vibration. If this thing vibrates, you won't get a clean cut. Your angle grinder blades could shatter in your face, and that's pretty much it. Now, what I'm going to be chopping through today is this almost 10-pound piece of quarter-inch copper-coated stainless steel. It's not nearly the toughest thing I chop up, but it's a good demonstrator. Now, you don't want to lay this big, heavy thing down on a flat surface and basically just slide it across. There's going to be a lot of uneven pressure that way. And remember, you're still putting a lot of force on just that little tiny little cutting blade of your angle grinder. To reduce that, basically these are just long pieces of steel that I actually got for free. I can imagine you could find something along these lines to do the job. What you do, you lay them down on your workbench, clear space. What this allows you to do is to gently, consistently, and methodically push your cutting item into the blade on a nice straight cut. It's time to actually set up the rig. Now, basically your guide, your clamps, and the cutting tool that for some reason I want to call Robbie. This setup is basically going to be clamped down. You can see my workbench is not pretty. Again, not pretty, it's functional. I take these clamps. As that text, and that's how it works. I have this really nice long straight cut. It doesn't go all the way through, unfortunately, but that's not how metal cutting works, unfortunately. If you actually attach this thing to a ruler, it'd be perfect. And it felt really nice. That's how you do it.